ready to match the stars. Clifton Davis, Rhett Summers, Gary Murtaugh, Joanne Flew, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene
One.
I don't even have a finish for this.
Sit down.
Well, you've never had a finish before. Why should you start now?
I mean, everybody's been affected by the Mel Brooks movie, and he's playing Igor as Igor, as they say in it.
Gene,
he's playing Igor. I said that was Frankenstein.
Hey, Gene, I didn't know you did Match Game on location at Bellevue.
Sort of manic depressives. I all settled down now.
Yeah. You sure not backwards?
You don't say that. They don't. They
yes, she leave it certainly out. Leave does, doesn't
sit
she?
Down.
Say heel.
Heel. No, she's all right. Is that Orphan Annie?
Yes.
Now, what's in the back?
Raggedy.
No, this is Raggedy Andy.
Oh, that's Raggedy Andy.
That's Andy.
Oh, that's Andy.
This is Annie.
And Raggedy Ann. Okay, just checking.
Okay.
Want to see your front and back before we go on here? I'd like to say hello to Mary King. Shall we do that? Hello, Mary King.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine.
How much money you got?
A lot.
A lot?
A lot.
$5,700.
Okay.
What are you going to do with all that money?
Oh, we need it. We just took a move and took a cut and pay, so we need it.
You took a what?
A move.
A move.
Uh-huh.
Oh, your husband took a cut and
right,
pay.
Right, to go up north to be in the beautiful country, so.
Oh, I see.
We
so
don't
the
need,
money's,
but
money's going to come in very handy.
Really?
All right, now, you're going to have a go at the audience match. Go at another $5,000 or more, and we'll see how that turns out right after we see about this message for you. Here we are with Mary King, who's won her second game. She's up here for the second time. She had a perfect round the first time with $5,700. Now she's going to try to add to her winnings. Are you ready, Mary?
I'm ready.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Mount Blanc. Now the answer they gave most often is worth $500, remember. If you match the next one, it's $250. And the third, $100. Time to call on three celebrities, one at a time.
Old Richard.
There's Old Richard.
Mount Everest.
Mount Everest.
Fanny? Strange you should say that, Richard. Olympic. Mount Olympic.
No? There is no Mount Olympic. There was a Mount Olympus.
That's what she meant.
You meant Mount Olympus? Okay, she meant Mount Olympus.
She said it three times.
You can't say Mount Olympic. Mount Olympus, okay? All right, there you go. There's two.
And Brett.
How about Mount Everest?
No.
He said Mount Everest.
Oh, he did. Oh, how
aren't
about
you
Mount
listening?
Shasta?
Mount who?
Whatever that place is, that northern.
Mount.
No, is it like a Shasta or a Shasta?
Mount Shasta?
Yeah.
Okay, she says Mount Shasta, so that gives you Mount Shasta, Mount Everest, and Mount Olympus. Three mountains. You want to choose one of those or give us one of your own mountains?
I'll say Mount Everest.
You'll say Mount Everest. Okay, we'll find out if it's up there. And if it's there, where is it? That is the question. We got to start at the bottom and reveal first the $100 response. Mount Sinai.
Huh.
That's a big mountain.
Yes.
That's
or
in the
a
Old Testament.
Or whatever.
That's a tablet they should have taken
now,
before the show.
Still looking for Mount Everest. Here is the $250 response. Mount Everest it is. Congratulations. Okay. What? You think it's Mount Vernon?
No, Mount Olympus.
What do you think it is? Says it's Mount Rushmore. We're going to find out right now. What is it? Mount Rushmore. You're right. Did you think of Mount Rushmore? You didn't. I didn't think of Mount Rushmore either. Okay, so you got the Everest. That means you're going to play for $2,500. Now it's time to choose one again and match that celebrity head-to-head. This has to be an exact match.
Right. I'll stick with Richard.
Going to stick with Richard. Okay, you'll face me, if you would, please, Mary King, and I'll get the $2,500 question for Richard. Blank baby. Blank baby. B-A-B-Y. Blank baby. They're both thinking about it. Blank baby. Blank baby.
There's just so many, I can't...
Really? Well, you better write one down.
But just choose one, dear.
Okay, just in the nick of time, the tape was running out.
There's hundreds, okay. But I can't think of one.
Now,
that would be...
we'll see what answer Mary will come up with in order to match you. Blank baby.
Doll baby.
Doll baby? That's the only thing you can think of?
Well, I have a baby. I thought a Gerber baby, but that's because I have a baby.
You have a baby.
I didn't say that. Richard doesn't have a baby. Either.
All right. So she says doll baby will match you.
There was some little or cute baby. And, you know, I it's brand new baby. That
brand
was
new baby. What was that first thought you had? Were you going
to... I had a little
pretty
baby.
Pretty baby. You were going to say pretty baby.
Pretty baby. Yeah. I started it right. But it...
There are no audience. What would you
bouncing
have said?
Bouncing baby.
I can't figure it out. I don't think they've got a good... You must have been a beautiful baby.
Beautiful baby?
Cry baby. That's a good one. Just in the nick of time. All right, now, where were you when we needed you?
Well, let's do it again.
Let's do it again. Let's play another game, shall we? And let's welcome another player. Here comes Perry Jones. Perry Jones will tell us a little bit about himself, if you would please, sir.
I'm a Los Angeles police officer, currently assigned to Southwest Investigative Unit. I'm married, I have three boys.
Okay, Perry, welcome to our program. Thank you. Are you ready to play?
Yes, I am.
Oh, we can't play now. We got to do a commercial. Can you stand by for another minute
sure,
or so?
No
will
problem.
You stay? All right, a minute and 8 seconds, we'll start this game. First this. All right. For you, Perry. I tell you, friends, we got a wild audience in this studio and howling. Yeah, what'd you take? I mean, where'd you come from now? Well, we better get on with the business here then. All right, Perry, it's your turn to make a selection.
Hey,
here we go. Everybody plays, new game.
We certainly do.
I have a job offer for Brett.
Now, I want you to be very careful.
Okay. Very careful. Dear Miss Summers, we have watched your work on Match Game and feel you belong in commercials. We would like you to play the part of a lady whose blank is stopped up. I just wanted to make sure she understood. We have watched you work on one match game. If you belong commercials, we want you to play the part of a lady whose blank is stopped up. Write something on your card.
Did you notice, you know, Brett has a lot of lovely fans. They sent her a present, which she's wearing. They are earrings that have a holster and a gun for pierced ears. And she has them on, and she doesn't have pierced ears. And I was curious to know how she's keeping them on.
Dug them in my skin.
Tell you one thing.
Some sweet lady sent them to me from Texas.
Oh, isn't that great? Does it hurt?
No, but her
it hurts.
But her lobes are half shot.
Ready? So we'll come over here to Perry Jones. The job offer for Brett, Perry. Dear Miss Summers, we've watched your work on Match Game and feel you belong in commercials. We'd like you to play the part of a lady whose blank is stopped up.
Sink.
Whose sink is stopped up.
That's logical.
Perry's playing it straight. How about you, Clifton?
I wanted to. You know, I looked at Brett and I knew that her toilet be stopped up, but... But as soon as I saw Perry, I knew we were going to match, brother. Except you a cop, man. I don't know. She's sick. She's sick.
Okay, there's one. All right. right, Brett.
You didn't think I was going to sell my soul for no man's gold, did you?
No.
My sink is stopped.
Very good, Gary. That's two for you. Keep it rolling, Gary.
He spends a lot of time in there upstairs. You know that?
Yes.
But nothing ever flushes. I don't understand.
Just give us your answer.
My complexion.
Please give us your answer. Well, I hope this is a match. I said drain.
Drain?
Is that a match? Yeah. Okay.
Perry is really rolling along here. We would like you to play the part of a lady whose blank is stopped up, and Perry said sink. What do you say?
Well, Brett is always so lovely. She calls me dummy when I come on the show. It makes me feel welcome. So the first thing that popped into my mind was something very nasty and mean.
I said toilet.
Okay. All right. So that's three for him.
She's going to be a mother.
Yes, she is.
How can you be so mean to my friend Brett?
The great one is about
to
speak.
You are correct, by the way. Her toilet is stuck. With dirty dishes.
Toity.
Toity.
All right. Last chance, Perry,
to match. Do you understand that they do not know Brett?
What?
The obvious, her brain.
Her brain.
That was not nice, friend.
Your friend. That's your friend, Fanny Flay.
Right.
Now let's see how Mary King does with her first round question. As the frontier doctor bandaged the young cowboy's lip, he said, boy.
Does this have to rhyme?
Boy, I don't care how lonely it is on the prairie. It was crazy of you to kiss a blank. That's what the frontier doctor said.
What, honey?
He said, boy. As he bandaged the young cowboy's lip, boy, I don't care how lonely it is on the prairie. It was crazy of you to kiss a blank.
Oh, I know what the answer is.
One of those.
Draw a picture of it if you can't think of the word.
Penguin is what you're looking for. No, that was three shows ago. Oh, she should have written.
Did you ever send in one of those matchbook covers where you could win a few dollars if you
threw it? They sent her back a book of matches.
We'll figure it out. All right,
I don't know what she drew, but I think it's clogged.
No, put it in
there because the light lights up and I know you're finished. All right, everybody all set? Mary King. As the frontier doctor bandaged the young cowboy's lip, he said, boy, I don't care how lonely it is on the prairie. It was crazy of you to kiss a blank.
Cactus?
Kiss a cactus.
Kissing cactus.
Kissing cactus. That's what she said. What do you say, Clifton?
Oh, no, he's a little freakier than that.
Really?
Yeah, he was sucking on a buffalo's lips.
We may have him back anyway. Don't worry about it, man. Okay, Brett, you're on.
I want to know what this looks like. Does that look like a cactus?
No. That's her answer. Whatever it is, that's her answer. And it doesn't match cactus. Prairie dog, coyote.
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 She said to me, she leaned over and she said, what is that thing on the prairie that goes, oh, I said you in singing class. I said cactus.
All right. There's another one for you. Our first one for Mary. Kissing cactus. No? No, you've got to show it. You don't
Do
seem very
to?
Proud of it, but you've got to show
it. Remind me of some joke, but now that I think about it, it was wrong.
It was?
Yes. I said a snake. Snake?
Well, yes, it was crazy to kiss a snake. Okay.
Picture.
Snake bit him right in the lip there. Okay.
I'm sorry, Mary.
All right.
If you're really lonely.
Yes.
I mean, you're not going to kiss a cat because you're not going to get anything back.
Right.
You need something. I always go for steers.
Steers?
Take them for a malted later.
Perfect.
And they never tell.
White face, right. Okay, Fanny.
Yes. I'm television oriented, I suppose, because I said Cartwright brother. They are. They don't like you to kiss them.
One of them likes kissing, I hear. Okay, so at the end of round one, 3-1, favor Perry Jones. Round two coming up, but first this. All right, here we go. Round two coming up. Now, Perry, please make selection.
A again, please.
A again. Last time you matched three of our celebrities, the upper tier. So this is just for the lower tier. Mm-hmm. Are you listening, lower tier?
Oh, yeah.
Here's
what
goes.
Do we do?
Shirley Temple said,
tier.
She said, gee willikers, my mommy made me leave the Good Ship Lollipop because I got blank. That's what Shirley Temple said. My mommy made me leave the Good Ship Lollipop because I got blank.
Good Ship Lollipop, it's a hot trip to a da-da-da.
Excuse me. How can I concentrate?
Music has charms to soothe
give
the savage.
Give her something
to
keep her busy with.
On the Good Ship Lollipop.
That's enough.
Wait a minute.
Now we go to
Perry
Jones.
Do I fucking wing yet?
Shirley Temple said, gee willikers, my mommy made me leave the Good Ship Lollipop because I got blank.
Pregnant.
Did you say you?
One host to a show, if you please. Did you say you're on the Vice Squad? Okay. Joanne.
Yes.
He said pregnant. My mommy made me leave the Good Ship Lollipop because I got pregnant.
Officer, really?
That's what he said.
I mean, I was just going to say, I admired him very, very much because I had to go to the police academy and learn how to be a police officer.
Oh,
for
you
a
did?
Show.
Yeah.
It was, you all go through it. It's really tough. Oh, and I learned how to beat up everybody. I don't want to tell him my answer, Brett.
What, you got a dumb answer again?
It's a very good answer.
Oh.
It doesn't coincide, but I said sick.
Yes, mild and merry.
That's the same answer?
No.
No?
No, that's morning sickness you're thinking
of.
This is something else.
Oh.
All right, would you like to put that in the slot there?
Sorry.
Just don't get too close to me because... All right.
Shirley Temple's our roving ambassador.
Yes, she is.
Very bright lady. They asked her what she thought of red china. She said, I thought it was very nicely on a blue tablecloth. I said, pregnant.
There it is. A wonderful day. Fanny Flagg, you're at bat.
Yes, Shirley Temple is also says she has a bill going through. She wants to send people to the sun, and they said it's too hot to go there. She said, we'll go at night. Now, wait a minute. Now, if you're on the Good Ship Lollipop, you get fat.
Why?
You eat candy.
All those lollipops.
Oh,
I see. Okay.
Don't you?
I would have picked up one there, Perry. Now let's see how Mary King does. Mary, you've got your work cut out for you. You need three to stay in the game, four to win. This is an important moment for Mary here.
Now,
pay attention.
Okay.
Who's the one who does not play? Gary does not play.
I'm the one.
Gary said Elon said she got scurvy.
Because it's so important.
I got a riddle for you. Everyone but you, Gary. You lay out.
All right.
The riddle goes as follows. What do you feed a catfish? The answer, a blank fish.
Holy mackerel.
The riddle is, what do you feed a catfish? The answer, a blank fish.
Gee, got some new wave questions. Terrific.
Good.
You ought to be out in New York.
What do you feed a catfish? The answer, a blank fish. Just write something.
Do-da.
No singing. Writing. It's writing time.
What did you write?
Oh, put it in the slot there, if you please, sir. Quickly, Brett. All right, we got the idea. Just put it right in the slot.
Well, just a minute.
Okay. Now, Mary King, the riddle. What do you feed a catfish? The answer, a blank fish.
A tuna fish.
What do you feed a catfish?
Yeah.
The answer, a blank fish.
What a catfish.
You're going to find out right now. Little touch of humor in this question there.
Oh.
I think. Oh, we're going to find out. Clifton, is there a touch of humor in this question, in this riddle there? Wake up, Clifton.
Yes, there is a touch of humor because it's a mouse fish.
A mouse fish. Catfish. Mouse fish. Okay.
I want
she said
exactly
tuna fish.
The same decibel rate.
Now, Mary, you got to match the three remaining ones to stay in the game and score a tie. Let's see if it happens. Okay, Joanne.
I first thought of another fish, then I thought of a dead fish.
Yep.
But then it screamed out so obvious that I had to put a mouse fish.
Mouse fish. So, Mary Jones wins the game. What do you have there? You would have done great with mouse fish, but it didn't cross your mind, did you?
It did.
We do a little play on words
I'm
there.
I'm in another world.
You are. Well, you won so much money, you're a little bit excited. You won $5,950.
Thank you so much.
Here we are. Here we are. I just want to thank all of these beautiful and celebrated people for the excellent job they did. And with this responsive audience here, you were just terrific.
Thank you.
And remember to watch audience. Clifton Davis in That's My Mama.
He's right. Terrific. He's
Gossam
funny.
Adam loves Clifton.
He's
on
funny
that
on this show.
That's
keep
right.
watching Adam.
I love Clifton on this show.
Yes,
isn't
he's very
good.
Good. This is the first time he's been
I
around.
I love Joanne Flug.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, we love on several
somebody's
shows.
Loved Joanne Flug.
Speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.